He runs because he knows he cannot hide. He's never gonna make it. All the poor people he's forsaken. Karma is always gonna chase him for his life.
This is part 6 to What If Naruto Was a Child Again. We left off with Naruto telling Boruto to finish off Momoshiki so he gains the Karma Seal. So now Boruto, Sasuke, and Naruto all have Karma Seals. Naruto decides to train Boruto a little to teach him how to use Karma properly. They train every day until Boruto can activate his Karma at will. This takes around a month. Boruto Imp Base is around 10% stronger than his canon counterpart. However, for the sake of the story, when he uses Karma, he can use 15% of Momoshiki's power. A couple of weeks pass, and they set out on a new mission. This is when they encounter Ao. They begin to combat him, and Boruto gets a good few hits in. Mitsuki then wraps his snakes around Ao, holding him in place. Sarada then uses her chakra enhanced punch to punch him into the ground. Konohamaru is about to finish Ao off with a Rasengan when Kashin Koji appears, stomping on him with his toad. This is when they fight Kashin Koji. Unfortunately, the same happens in canon, and Konohamaru gets destroyed. Kashin Koji then uses a jutsu to try to finish off Konohamaru. This being fire style toad bomb jutsu. However, this is when Boruto activates his Karma Seal and absorbs the jutsu. Kashin Koji looks at Boruto surprised, thinking that Naruto Uzumaki killed Momoshiki. But no, it was Boruto Uzumaki. Kashin Koji then wears out Boruto and the rest of the team before he leaves, saying that they showed him something quite interesting as he leaves. Konohamaru eventually recovers, and they stumble upon Kawaki. Boruto notices his Karma Seal and says that they should definitely take him back to the village, as he looks like he could be very important. So they do just that and bring him back to the village. Back in the village, Sasuke is called back and Naruto meets Kawaki. Naruto then tells Kawaki, "I'm Naruto Uzumaki, the Hokage, or in other terms, the leader of the village. What is your name?" Kawaki responds with his name, and Naruto begins taking Kawaki back to his home. Suddenly, Kawaki tries to escape. However, Naruto appears in front of him. This surprises Kawaki, who then decides to follow Naruto home. They enter Naruto's home, and they are sitting at the table, when Kawaki thinks he might be able to escape again. So, Kawaki tries to escape. However, Naruto activates KCM2 and Sage Mode, which makes Kawaki think that Naruto may be stronger than Jigen. Naruto in base is 2 times stronger than his canon counterpart. Kawaki then decides to give up, as there is no way he is escaping Naruto. Later on, Naruto and Kawaki are talking, and Naruto decides that he will train Kawaki. Naruto trains with Boruto and Kawaki and is fighting them both 2v1 in base form, whilst Kawaki and Boruto use their Karma Seals. Naruto can control his Karma Seal so it doesn't activate when they activate theirs. They do this every day for a week, and by the end of the week, Boruto can use 16% of Momoshiki's power, and Kawaki can use 10% of Jigen's power. Suddenly, Delta attacks. Naruto remembers that she will self-destruct if defeated, and she tried to hurt Himawari. Naruto activates Sage Mode and fights Delta. Delta rushes at Naruto and tries to punch him several times. But Naruto manages to dodge all of these punches and then counters with his own punch. However, Delta dodges this. However, Naruto then smokes as she gets sent flying into a tree. This is because Naruto used Frog Kumite. Delta stands back up and starts using her beams. Naruto dodges all of these with ease when suddenly his sage mode runs out. Naruto then says, "Kurama, are you ready?" Kurama says yes as Naruto activates normal KCM2. Naruto then blitzes in front of Delta and stands there momentarily, which makes Delta use her light beam, which Naruto easily dodges. Naruto then uses a giant Rasengan on Delta, who absorbs it. However, Naruto continues feeding Delta chakra, which overwhelms her, causing the chakra absorber to stop working. Naruto then uses a final Rasengan, killing Delta. Kawaki and Boruto are absolutely amazed at how Naruto just fondled Delta so easily, as she is known as one of the stronger members in Kara. Naruto then schedules an immediate meeting with Sasuke, so he can discuss what has just happened with the Kara Elder Delta. This is the end to part 6 of What If Naruto Became a Child Again. I hope you all enjoyed, and if you did, consider liking and subscribing. Big shout out to Headhunter for making my intro. Feel free to check out his channel.